guys, this is Mark. We just released version 5.7.0 of Backendless with some very exciting and some very significant part of functionality. In this version, what we did, we completely redesigned and revamped the geolocation storage in Backendless. And previously, geolocation was really just a separate storage of the geopoints that you could link to your data objects. And we saw that there were a lot of deficiencies with this approach, where geolocation and geopoints were treated as a sort of related storage that you had to deal with through object relations, and it was quite inconvenient. So starting with 5.7.0, geolocation is essentially an integral part of the database storage, where you could create columns and properties of the geolocation types. So for example, let's say I have this users table and I want to add the concept of location for the user. So right in schema, when you create a new column, and let's call that column location, the data types that we have added include point, line, string, and polygon. Where point is just a single location with two coordinates on the map. Line string is sort of a path where it's a collection of points all connected together into kind of one single root. And the polygon is a closed shape sort of on the surface that can represent something two-dimensional, for example, an outline of a building or a state or some sort of geozone. So let's say I want to add the point as the data type for the location for my users. And now in the data browser, there is going to be the location column. And in this column, you can populate it using the API because we have updated all the SDKs that include capability to store locations such as points, line strings, and polygons. You can retrieve data, and I'm going to demonstrate all of this shortly to you. But most importantly, in Backendless Console, we added an ability to actually visualize and manage your data. Like for example, previously you could not add a geo point right from the console, but now it's super simple to do this. So for instance, there is this checkbox called visualize that will display all the locations that you have in this specific column. Right now there is no data, so let's just add one. If we click on this little icon that says open geometry editor, it opens a map where you can add that location for that specific point for the user using either map view or using text view. And in the text view, you specify the location either in WKT, which is well-known text format, or using GeoJSON structure and syntax, which is an industry standard syntax for describing geolocations. So let's say that that particular person that I'm adding a location for is in Dallas. So you just click on Dallas. It automatically translates this particular location to the latitude and longitude. You click save, and now there is a location for that particular user right in the database. The cool thing about it is that locations and all the spatial types in Backendless are treated as really just the primary data types, meaning that when you retrieve data for your data objects, in addition to all the basic properties such as age, which is double, and email, which is string, location is going to be returned as well as one of the primary data types. You do not need to configure any relations. You do not need to go into any complexity with the APIs to retrieve that data as just with your objects. It's going to come back right there. So for instance, let's say that we want to retrieve data for that particular user. Let's get the object ID for that user and switch to REST console. So we paste the object ID and then we click get. We will be retrieving that particular user. Now notice that the location property is automatically there, and it has this structure, which is the GeoJSON structure. So that's how the location properties are going to be, all the spatial types are going to be returned back to you if you use the REST API. If you use any of our SDKs, such as Android, iOS, JavaScript, .NET, so all of the SDKs have been updated where when you retrieve an object that has a spatial type, you will basically be getting and objects representing special types of the specialized classes that we put into the SDK. And of course, the APIs are there to update the location, the point properties or the line string properties. You can delete these values. So all the basic elements of working with data create, retrieve, update, delete, the full CRUD is there. Going back to this, so you can have multiple columns of this particular type. So here, for instance, I have a table called order. And then, as you can see, in the order, I have the pickup location and the drop-off location for a particular order. If I click visualize, you can notice that you can assign different colors to various columns. So for this, for the drop-off location, it is blue. So if I start zooming in to see the data for that particular order, then you'll see that there are two data points here. This is the pickup location, this is the drop-off location. Super convenient. The data in console by default is rendered in the WKT format, which is an industry standard format for representing spatial data. You can switch to JSON just by clicking this particular toggle, and it goes back and forth. Now, these are still just the points. I also have a demo of the path, which is the line string. There's a path column, and in the line string, if we just zoom out, we will see that this particular path right here is all encoded in this particular property. So this is the root, historic root 66, and is all encoded as a single property in this particular object. If we go to REST console and click get, then we're going to get this path property, and this is the GeoJSON for that particular path, and it's all right there as a single property in your object. And as you can see, this is just way, way better than what the previous implementation of the backendless geolocation was. Likewise, if you're working with polygons, which represent closed areas on the map, as I said, it could be an outline of a state or any particular geozone, or in this case, I do have a table called building, and in here there is one object with the name of it is pentagon, and the shape column is of the type of polygon. So if we start zooming in on that particular value, then you will see that it's right in Washington DC, and it is going to be the outline of the Pentagon building. So as you can see, it's right there. And then for the polygon properties, you can define the outer boundary, and you can define the inner boundary. And then the inner boundary is going to be called hole. So in fact, if I go to open the geometry editor, you can see that there is an exterior boundary and interior boundary. And you can define multiple interior boundaries through the APIs. In console, you can define only one. And console is really more just to kind of get the basic idea of the visualization, but you would be working primarily using the APIs. But anyway, it is right there, and you can actually edit this by dragging it out, and you can see that the coordinates are automatically updated. Let's cancel out, because this is not really the shape of the pentagon. Anyway, it is all right there, ready for you to use, I think it came out really beautifully, because we managed to really accomplish what with the goals that we set for us, to bring geolocation right into the database. And that's the new geolocation in Backendless. Thank you, and as always, happy coding.